Here again, joined by
Abby Lee.
Abby, thanks for coming out. You know, we talked a little bit behind the scenes here. I know you sort of aren't, you know, in per se the esports scene as far as gaming, but you're really interested in it as a sort of, you know, how it, the dynamics work with, you know, different games. You were talking about EA and that whole debacle with their, you know, pay to win sort of pay for extra, you know, stuff. So you want to talk about a little bit more about that, you know, what your experience is like and how it, you know, sort of feels in the esports scene as almost an outsider, but still kind of looking in.
So I'm definitely an outsider. I don't play. I don't have like a Discord or Twitch or anything. I'm just learning about this stuff. So I go to Temple University, which is in North Philly, and I study media studies and production. I actually just graduated, but I'm in their grad program. And something that's always intrigued me was just the world of esports. It's like really, it's just going, like whether people realize it or not. And so what something on the outside I've realized and what I've heard from other people, especially people outside of the media production world, is the judgments on the social aspects. So I kind of came in to get to know how this works, who the people are, how they decide their teams. And even so far, I've met people that connect, like one kid's from Utah and flew in, and then his partner's from Maryland, and like they drove here to play. So it's honestly insane, like how much how esports brings people together. And it's really nice to be in Philly, which is kind of on the forefront since Xfinity's in the process of building an esports stadium.
Absolutely. And can you tell me more about sort of your experience today? I know you said maybe you played Halo back in the day a little bit when you were young, but that's your very little experience. And sort of as someone being just a spectator in sort of like, I guess, in any other sport, maybe you haven't played football and you watch it for the first time. How is it as a spectator kind of without that knowledge? And are you like, you know, sort of learning a few things and kind of getting the feel of things? You know, what's a cool play? What's you know, impressive or not?
I'm having so much fun. And I know that sounds kind of silly or like a joke, but I'm being dead serious. Like everyone's been really nice. And so I played video games when I was younger, like Halo 1 through 3, or if you guys remember, the very original Xbox came with like free games, and on one side was a racing game, and on the other side was a game called Radio Jet Set Future, which is like a blast from the past, a really fun game. And so I kind of knew how the games work, and even now stuff is coming back to me. But I realized that when I was younger, my cousins would talk in the headset for me because people were really mean or like didn't like that a girl was playing, or the opposite, and treat me differently for being a girl. So coming here has shown me that people still play Halo 3 very religiously. There's some games like the Fredericksburg team that has a coach, which I'm learning about, which is like insane. I'm listening to the commentators through the Twitch. I actually went outside and hung out with a team and watched them in real time play, or watch themselves play. So they had played 15 minutes ago and then just critique themselves, which is something that you don't get in other sports. And then something that drew me to this also was that, again, the social aspect of when baseball lacks in this, but like football and basketball are really good, is that you kind of get to know the characters. You get to know, but exactly, they're building a character, they're building some kind of presence for themselves, you know, where they went to college, you might know about their parents, you might know where they grew up. And so I think that's something that I would like to see more, kind of like a baseball card of like, here's their facts, here's the games they play, here's where they're from, here's a fun fact, just get to know them better. So that's kind of...
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think a lot of people don't realize sort of how close it is to, you know, other sports, as far as there's the storylines, there's, you know, real competitors, there's coaches, there's all this background stuff.
Between the character, or I did it again. but yeah, the relationships between the teams, because some of the guys have been gaming, or people have been gaming together for literal years, whereas other teams have just come together for this event. So I even overheard people talking about, okay, we noticed that like we are playing this certain way, so we have to get better at this as together, and like you have to improve on this individually, which is something that I would never think about having not been in this situation myself.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, people look at replays. It's a lot of the very same things that you see in other sports. And like you said, it seems to be that Philadelphia is going to be maybe a hub soon for esports in the East Coast, especially the Northeast, with the stadium coming for the Overwatch team. Tell me more about your experience here besides that. Like you said, you met a lot of really cool people. you know, there is still that sometimes that toxicity online, but you really do see when you're in person, and that's what I love about LANs, people are nice. So, like, you can be competitive, and sometimes it gets heated up there while they're gaming, but when you're out here, it's a totally different environment. Super nice. So are you going to come to more LAN events after this? Are you excited to kind of experience more of esports as an outsider, maybe start playing some yourself even, learn a little bit? You don't have to, but, you know, just interested to see what you think about that. Or do you think esports can be sort of consumed by everybody, like every consumer? You don't have to play games to appreciate it.
Right. So I definitely plan to go to more events. There's one coming up in New Jersey in September. And already multiple people are like, are you going to come? And I'm like, well, now I am. Like, I have friends now. And there's all sorts of people here. There's even like parents here. And obviously I'm an observer, whereas like there's a lot of people that are in it. So I expect to go to more. I also learned about, like, I've heard of LAN, but I understand that it's a lot more fun to watch and do these kind of events because your connection's better and it's just easier to play. And also just to see each other in person. And yeah, like, people talk smack in the comments, but in person, they're all really nice. People are like, oh, do you want to watch my stream? Or do you want to like come sit with me? Or even you were so nice and we got pizza together. So I expect to definitely come out to more stuff.
Absolutely. I mean, you'll definitely still see some smack talk. I don't know if you'll watch some of these interviews later. There's a couple people that are smack talking each other, but it's all in good fun. Yeah,
it's
so
a game.
It's a game. It's supposed to be competitive. So, you know, we're glad to have you. Definitely come by again. Is there any last thoughts you have on this or something you want to share before I let you go?
That's giving me a lot of power. Honestly, I think I was, believe it or not, very nervous to come out to this because I don't game and I'm not really in the community. But like I said, like, once I got here, people were really nice and really inviting. And actually the reason I came out here was because originally I connected with Adam Nelson on LinkedIn and he was so nice to me on LinkedIn, and that's what encouraged me to come out alone today, and it was definitely worth it. So if you're even just a little curious, it's kind of fun to watch it and understand why people come out.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Thanks for coming by. Take care.